In this video, we're gonna find out why the Sega Genesis button inputs don't work. Confirming the accuracy of the sales description, I figured this fix would be pretty straightforward. Boy, was I wrong. Usually this control pad issue occurs when someone trips over the connected cable, causing the console to go flying and breaking a solder joint in the process. Examining the mainboard and checking for continuity didn't leave any clues either. Since there isn't anything obvious, let's reflow the connections anyway in hopes of solving it. Since we need a convenient way of showcasing how this console is behaving, let's enlist the help of a familiar friend. If only this Game Gear could play Genesis games. It may be crude, but it gets the job done for testing purposes. Even reflowing the controller ports has no impact. I couldn't wrap my head around the problem being anything other than these port connections, so I reflowed it again. The specific problem that is being encountered is that the A and B buttons of player 1 don't work, yet the inverse is happening for player 2's buttons. Are these MOSFETs faulty? I've never encountered a faulty MOSFET, but we're running out of options here. Testing them for continuity with the controller ports didn't turn up anything either. What the hell is going on? I hadn't read the schematic for this board yet, but I wanted to rule out if one controller port was influencing the other, so I disconnected player 2's MOSFETs entirely. Each controller technically has their own dedicated trace to the ASIC, but I had to be sure. And still nothing. This Genesis is turning out to be a royal pain. So I started testing each MOSFET and mapping them out on paper in a process of elimination. I even took the tested good MOSFETs and swapped them to the defective button channels. After going through every single MOSFET and proving they were all good, it was time to get drastic. I had already tested this controller port for continuity, but it wouldn't hurt to refurbish it in the process. Man, I already hate this console. In a bit of desperation, I forced player 2's inputs onto player 1's to see if it would reveal a clue to what was happening. I couldn't believe it. I could control both players independently by pressing their only good working buttons. For a minute there, I was playing two-player Sonic solo. Without a doubt, there is no way the controller interface is bad, so I started following the traces from the controller to the ASIC and the ICs. Checking the schematic at console5.com, we could follow which button press goes where and trace it to its corresponding pin of the ASIC. Diagram 4 had the controller inputs with their corresponding codes in the top right. Pulling up Diagram 1, we could see which pins they go to and their pin number. In this case, pins 93 through 106 receive these inputs. And we could see where they are approximately by the identifiers on the main board. For example, the last pin on the bottom right, labeled 105, is the first player's start button. At this point, I'm pretty confident we can rule out the controller port. We can also rule out all these MOSFETs. The pins on the ASIC all checked out as well, and all the traces in between. This means that either the IC is bad, or this IC is bad. I don't even want to consider the ASIC, but I'm going to need to get some additional consoles if we're going to get to the bottom of this mystery. So I place this console in storage for it to be worked on another day. Having purchased a couple extra systems, I had the newfound confidence to figure out what the original console's malfunction was. According to the description, one won't power on and the other has a controller problem. Given that I was already on the hook for a Genesis with controller issues, I opted for the one that didn't turn on. After checking voltage in the usual places, I noticed something was off about its LED indicator. It's completely shattered. What the heck could have happened to cause that? How funny would it be if the LED indicator fooled the seller into thinking that this console was broken? And sure enough, this console plays just fine. I swear, I keep going back to this Game Gear mainboard to harvest its parts for various reasons. Let's take its LED and transplant it to this perfectly good Genesis. And boom. Well, that's one out of the way. Let's hope the next one is a simple reflow like I anticipated with the first one. And you're probably wondering why this Genesis has its port cut in half. Let's just say with this board, I had to be sure. Short of the chips having different manufacturers and a different ASIC revision, these VA1 components should theoretically be interchangeable. Wow, what are the chances that this board has its A and B buttons not working just like the first one? I hope these VA1 boards don't have the same manufacturing defect. After giving the controller ports a quick reflow, That's all that was needed to get this console back in good working order. Now that we know everything is working on this Genesis, let's harvest its circuitry and see if that's what malfunctioned on our original. We could start by swapping the easier IC4 to see if that fixes our issue. Well, I guess we can rule that one out for being the problem. Let's try IC5 and see if that solves it for us. And nope. This is the most stubborn console I've ever come across. At this time, it didn't even sink in until this point of what was required to be done. Sweet baby Jesus. There's like a gazillion more pins on this thing. Last time I did any sort of work like this was on that SIF Game Gear. At least you could count the pins on that thing. In the end, I managed to remove the ASICs with some minor bruises. Let me tell you though, bending these pins manually by eye is a royal pain in the ass. We got it though. After installing our suspect ASIC onto our known good board, our suspicions have been confirmed. Yep, the exact same issue as the first. The A and B buttons are not working while the C and start remain unscathed. At this point, the mystery had been revealed, and I had no desire to fix the original Genesis that I'd butchered and battered. Transferring an ASIC once is stressful enough, but to do it again? So I put the better looking Genesis together and called it a day. 2 out of 3 ain't bad, right? Except, I thought back to how that first Genesis taunted me. It's probably laughing at me right now. So I got another one. This one would be the martyr. I'm not even going to diagnose it. All I need it for is the ASIC, and I will fix it. Except, there's one small issue with that first Genesis I hadn't disclosed. During the first ASIC removal, I managed to peel up some pads in the corner. In fact, after dry fitting the ASIC onto the first Genesis, I got cold feet and did the very thing I didn't want to do. I reattached the ASIC back to the fourth Genesis and diagnosed it. After reflowing the DC socket, I now had 3 out of 4 working consoles. But that first Genesis was still bugging me. How could I let that inanimate hunk of junk get away with this? Why couldn't it have accepted its repair like all the others? So I asked you all to decide how this should end. Your wish is my command.
Warning. Fixing it until it's broken is for entertainment purposes only and should not be attempted in any circumstance, especially by this head.
Let's throw all logic and practicality out the window and send it off with a bang. I'm starting to get good at these ASIC transfers, but my doubts have increased 100-fold after looking at this malign mess. But what's this? Will this console live to play again? So I went over each and every pin with a fine-tooth comb. Fluxing. Searching. Prodding. Oh my god, live! Sadly, in the end, all it would show is the Sega licensing information, and it never booted again. As far as fixing it until it's broken is concerned, well, I fiddled with those pins until they snapped clean off.
If you like this video, why don't you check this one out over here where I give a Game Boy a swirly. Otherwise, if you have any questions or comments, go ahead and leave them down below. And as always, I'll see you next time. If you like this video, why don't you check this video out? If you like this video, why don't you check... If you like this video, what do you...